In this video, we're looking at a vertical free fall problem with an initial positive velocity as a rock is launched using a slingshot from a height of 2 meters above the ground. We're told to use a coordinate system with the origin at ground level and upward as positive. So that's probably the coordinate system you were going to use anyway. Again, the origin is at the ground, so we can put the crosshairs of our coordinate system there, and I'll put a little zero there to indicate that that's the origin. This means the initial height of the rock is 2 meters. Initial velocity is positive 45 meters per second. The acceleration is downward, so that will count as a negative 9.8. So in part A, we're just trying to get the height of the rock after 3 seconds. And the height of the rock as a function of time is given by our kinematics equation, y equals y naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. Or if you prefer, you could start from the next step where I plug in the acceleration, just remembering that my acceleration is negative g here. So that's the height as a function of time. And we can go ahead and plug in what was the initial height. That was 2 meters. What was the initial velocity? That was upward. It was positive 45 meters per second times the amount of time that's gone by. We're interested in the moment 3 seconds after the launch. And then minus a 1/2. Again, we're using the approximation 9.8 for g meters per second squared times t squared. So 3 seconds all squared. Our units all work out to meters. And when I crunch the numbers, I get 92.9 meters after 3 seconds of flight. In part B, we're looking at the same moment in time, 3 seconds after the launch, but this time I want to compute the velocity. So we use our kinematics equation, v equals v naught plus at, and we plug in what the acceleration is for this vertical free fall, which is negative g. And we plug in the numbers, and I get 45 meters per second minus 9.8 meters per second squared times 3 seconds. Our units work out to meters per second on each term, so that's good. And it turns out the rock is still headed upward. It has a velocity of positive 15.6 meters per second at this moment in time. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.